So chapter 7, variations. We'll see what is variation, what is the meaning of variations, and then we will solve sums on variations. So first let us understand what is variation. So we'll understand variation with an example. Everyone pay attention carefully. So we'll understand variation with an example. Suppose you go to purchase a notebook, your small notebook that you use, and you know that one notebook cost rupees 10. Okay, the cost of one notebook is rupees 10. Pay attention to this example. If you understand this example properly, you will understand what variation is. So suppose the cost of that notebook is rupees 10. Now look at this following table. Number of notebooks I am... Number of notebooks, I'm taking it to be X. So if you see this column, the first row, number of notebooks is X. And the cost of notebooks is, I'm calling it to be Y. So let the number of notebooks be X and let the cost of notebooks be Y. So if you see the first column in this table, one notebook is for 10 rupees. Okay, one notebook, 10 rupees. So if one notebook is for 10 rupees, three notebooks will be for 30 rupees. Five notebooks will be for 50 rupees. What we are doing, we are just multiplying. 5 into 10, 50, because one notebook is for 10 rupees. Similarly, if you see, 7 notebooks will be for 70 rupees. 10 notebooks will be for 100 rupees. Now, one thing that you have to note that as the value of X, that is number of notebooks, is increasing, okay? As the value of X, that is as the number of notebooks increases, the price of the notebook also increases. Okay, as the value of X, that is as the number of notebooks increases, cost of the notebooks also increases. So I'll use this in terms of variables. As X increases, Y also increases. So if you see, as the value of X changes, in our case, it is increasing. So I'm using the word change over here. It can be increasing, decreasing either, but it has to change. As the value of X changes, the variable Y also changes. This changing of variable parameters means numbers, okay? So the changing of variable parameters, that is called as variation, okay? The change in variable parameters or numbers, or in simple words, if I say change in one variable is causing the change in the second variable, or change in X is resulting in change in Y. So we can say that this is called as variation. Vanshika, pay attention here. Okay, so in simple terms, variation is as one variable changes, as the value of one variable changes, the value of the another variable will also change. So you can say as X increases, Y also increases, or as X decreases, Y also decreases. So basically it is change in one variable causing change in the other variable. That is nothing but variation.
So we have studied in 7th standard, direct proportion and inverse proportion.
Yes, yes. Same. It is called as proportion. Same, it is same.
Sir.
Yes. Yes. You have any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. So there are two types of variation. Okay. We'll be studying in this chapter of ours two types of variation. The first is called as a direct variation, or you can also call it as direct proportion. Okay. Direct variation. And the second is indirect variation, also called as inverse variation. Okay. First, we'll see about direct variation. We'll do some sums on direct variation, the exercise as well. Then after that, we will see indirect variation. Indirect variation is also called as inverse variation. Then we'll see sums and examples on inverse variation. Okay. Let us first see what is meaning of direct variation. Okay. Understand first properly what is direct variation. Pay attention carefully to the definition of direct variation. In a variation, if variable changes proportionately, understand the meaning, okay? In variation, if variables, or if I say if the value of variable changes proportionately. Now, the meaning of proportionately. Before that, let's understand this point and then I'll explain this, what is proportionately. Either increases or decreases together. Okay, understand this. That means, suppose if the value of the variable x increases, okay, suppose if the value of the variable x increases, then value of the y variable also should increase. Then we'll say it is direct variation. Or else, if the value of the variable x decreases, okay, then y also should decrease. Either one of these things should happen. Not both together cannot happen, okay? That means as x increases, y cannot decrease. This cannot happen in direct variation. In direct variation, what can happen is, that is, if x increases, y also should increase. Or if x decreases, y also should decrease. If this either one of this thing happens, then I will call it to be direct variation. Direct variation. Now the meaning of proportionate. Proportionate means by same amount. Okay. Proportionate means by same amount. So suppose if x increases by 10. Okay. Suppose if x increases by 10, then y also will increase by 10. That is meaning proportionately. So if x increases by 10, y also increases by 10. Or if x decreases by 10, then y will also decrease by 10. So this is called as direct variation. Now let us do some sums on direct variation. Then you understand it clearly. You'll get a more clear picture, a more clear understanding of direct variation. Before that, if x is in direct variation with y, okay, if I say if x is in direct variation in y, then symbolically in symbol, we write this as like this, x directly proportional to y. This way we write it symbolically and we call it, we say it as x directly proportional to y. Okay, so this is the way we write direct proportion.
Again, this.
If x and y are in direct proportion, then we write it like this. X direct, this symbol is for proportionate symbol. So we say x directly proportional to y. Now clear? This is just the way we write it. I am saying x directly proportional to y. And when you're writing it, we write it in this form. X directly proportional to y. Now is it clear, Ashutosh? Okay. Few points that you have to keep in mind here is, see, if x is directly proportional to y, now this, I want to write it in the form of equation. If you see, this is not an equation. I hope you all know, you all remember what is an equation. What is an equation? Can anyone tell me what is equation? What is equation? An expression that has equal to sign is called equation. Okay, an expression that has equal to sign is called an equation. So, if you see this x directly proportional to y, this by solving the sum, we need to convert this into equation. So, when you write this in equation form, this becomes as x is equal to ky, where k will be some constant. K will be some constant number which you have to solve and find out. Okay, so x directly proportional to y in the form of equation, we will write this as x is equal to ky, where k is some number. Okay, x and y are variable and k is a constant. So this is the way we write it in the form of equation. K is a constant. And if you want to find out the value of k, okay, if you want to find out the value of k, what you do is you take this y on the other side. So this is like this, x is equal to ky. You take the y on the other side. So when you take y on the other side, here it is in multiplication. And when you take it on the other side, it will get into division. So this becomes x divided by y is equal to k. This is the way we will find out the value of k. This is the way we will find out the value of k. K while solving the sum. So k is equal to x upon y. Okay. Now you see here, observe the following statements, how they are written in the symbol of variation. Okay, statements will be given and we have to write it in the form of mathematical symbol of variation. We have to use a symbol. So if you see the first one, see this, pay attention to this sum. Area of a circle is directly proportional to the square of its radius. We have to write this in the form of symbol. We have to write this in the form of symbol. So what we'll do first, area of the circle, we'll call it to be A, capital A. And radius of the circle, we'll denote it by small r. Now the statement says, area is directly proportional to the square of its radius. So we'll write it area directly proportional to square of the radius. So r square. A directly proportional to r square. This is the way we will write the statement in the symbolic form of variation. Is this clear?
Is the first one? Yes, sir.
R square.
See the statement. In the statement, it is said area of the circle is directly proportional to the square of its radius. Okay, square of its radius means r square. That is why we are taking r square here. Clear now?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
We see one more. See the second one. Pressure of a liquid, that is denoted by P, varies directly as the depth, that is D, of the liquid. So this statement, how will be written in direct proportion?
Sir, can I tell?
Yeah, tell me.
Pressure of a liquid is directly proportional to the depth of the liquid.
So we'll write it like this. P directly proportional to D. Correct?
Yes. Okay. Yes.
Okay. So, given a statement and you have to write it in the direct proportion symbolic form. This is the way we do it. So we'll see 7.1, the first part of this exercise. So the first part is write the following statement using symbol of variation. Now see the first one. Circumference, that is C, of a circle is directly proportional to its radius. So this statement, how will I write it in the form of symbol? Yeah, correct. we'll write this as C directly proportional to R. Okay, I hope you all can see it. I'll write it again. Circumference of the circle, that is C, directly proportional to the radius, that is R. See the second one. Consumption of petrol, denoted by small l. Consumption of petrol in a car and distance traveled by that car, that is D. Distance traveled is D, are in direct variation. So this statement, we can write it as L directly proportional to D.
So what you are writing in middle?
This symbol is of proportion. This symbol is called of proportion.
So we have to write this on, like this only?
Yes, yes, yes. You have to write it like this only. This way only it is mentioned in your textbook. Okay. This is the symbol for proportion.
Sir?
Yes?
In textbook, the symbol is written in another way. It is shown by A. Small
yes,
A.
Small like, A.
Small A. Wait, I don't know.
Yes.
I'll open
the textbook one. Yes, sir. Answer A is alpha. We read as alpha.
Okay, that's just a way of writing.
We can write it by your way.
This, right? We can write it what? See here, this is
we
same.
Can write it how you have written it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yes. It's the same thing. It's the same thing. Alpha. However you want, you can write it. But it should look like a proportionality symbol. That's it.
Yes.
Okay, like this. Okay.
It's like a design.
Yeah, like this. You can write it like this. You can write it like this. The meaning of this is the same. Proportionality symbol. It is a Greek letter, and that Greek letter is called as alpha. It is a Greek letter, and that Greek letter is called as alpha. But in our variation chapter, it is the meaning of that is a proportionality symbol. Okay, in our variation chapter, this symbol alpha is called as a proportionality symbol or the direct variation symbol or variation symbol, basically, not direct variation, variation symbol. Okay, this is the second sum of my practice set 7.1, and this says complete the following.
Sir, table.
Yeah.
Please show first slide.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, sir. Thanks.
So this is complete the following table, considering that the cost of apple and their number are in direct variation. So they have said that number of apples taken as X and cost of apples taken as Y. Okay, students, in case if the meeting ends, no, just rejoin, okay? I think it may end in 10 minutes, so just rejoin.
Yes.
Also, students, for your attendance, so now since the chat, for the attendance, just write present. Okay, we'll solve this sum. Number of apples are X and cost of apples are Y. So, it is given that cost of apples Y and number of apples X are in direct variation. It is given in the question, direct variation. So, If you see cost of apples and their number, so cost of apple is y, number of apples is x. That is why we have y directly proportional to x. Y directly proportional to x. After that, we have to write this in the equation form. We have to write this in equation form. So in equation form, this will become y is equal to kx in equation form. Now, if you see the first column here, in the first column, x is 1 and y is 8. Okay, x, that is number of apples, is 1 and cost of apple will be 8. Now we have to first find a value of k. So we know y is equal to k upon x. Now if you take the x on the other side, this will become y upon x is equal to k. So now we know the value of y and x. We'll substitute that. Y is 8, x is 1. 8 divided by 1 is 8 itself. So the value of k is 8. Is this up to here clear?
Yes.
Now if you see, in the third column, we need to find this value. Now we know the value of k. Now we can solve the sum. This was the important part. Now we'll do the main part of this. So we have to find this here. These blanks, you can see this blanks value, we have to find out now. Okay, let's do that now. So for that, we need two things. We need the value of k and we need this equation. Okay, we need this equation and
so we
need
the value of k.
Yeah, you can solve directly, but you have to write it properly.
Sir, in textbook answer is 7. X is equal to 7.
X is equal to 7. Which value? This? Yeah, the blank.
Yes, 7 at the 56.
Okay,
yeah. Now, how do you get that 7? We need to find out that.
56 divided by 7.
Yes, yes. We need that too. We need this and we need the value of k that we got it as 8. So, if you see in this block here, we need to find a value of x and y is 56. So, we'll use this equation. Y is equal to kx we will use. So y is 56, k is 8, and x we have to find out. We'll take 8 on the other side, it will get divided by 56. So 56 divided by 8, and that is 7. So that is how you get 7 here. Okay, is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, can you tell me this one? How will we do this portion?
Yes, sir.
The answer is 96.
96. Sir, it's 96. Okay, yeah. Let's see. We'll solve it. So, in this, x is 12. And y, we have to find out. Okay? Y, we have to find out. So this has to be found out. So y is equal to k into x. K is 8 and x is 12. 12 into 8 is 96. So this is 96 here. Similarly, in the same way we can do this. Can you tell me what will be the answer here?
20.
Okay, very good. 20. Okay, we'll still solve it and see. X has to be found out. Y is 160. So, y is equal to kx. This will be 160 here, 8x. So, x will be 160 divided by 8, which is nothing but 20. So, the value of x is 20. So, this was easy sum.
So, we have to write present now.
Yes, yes, write it in the chat box.
Yes.
Students, for attendance, just write present in chat box if you have not done it till now. Okay, so this is question 3, third question of the same exercise. Read the question first.
For the question number 2.
This is question 2.
Yes, sir, I have written over.
Okay, now let's go to the third question of this exercise, 7.1. Third question says, if M is directly proportional to N, value of M is 154, value of N is 7. We have to find the value of M when N is 14. Okay, let's solve this sum.
We will multiply 2 by 154.
Yeah, but we have to solve it properly. Correct, you're saying, but we have to solve it and yes. So. M is directly proportional to N. We have to write this proportionality into equality. So when you write it in equation, M will be equal to K into N. M value is 154 given in the question. K, first we have to find out. And N is 7. If you take 7 on the other side, what will happen? It will get divided. So 154 divided by 7, which 20. Is 20.
2.
So value of K is 22. So I know the value of K and I need this equation. These two things I need. Now if N is 14, we have to find the value of M. Use the equation and the value of K. M is equal to KN. K is 22. And N is 14. How much will be 22 multiplied by 14?
308.
So this is the value of M. Is this clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, question number 4.
Question number 4 is homework. Okay, I'll show you the question 4.
Okay, sir.
So see, the question 4 is table. Question 4 is a table. This table you have to find out. It's the same table as we did in our question 1. This question 2. Same way you have to solve this and find out the values here. So that is why I have given it for homework.
Sir, please show the...